Hey, it's Kaylee. This lesson is about the common elements on the periodic table of elements. Make sure you've already watched the periodic table basics video before watching this one. All right, let's get started. From the periodic table basics video, you know all about the organization of the periodic table of elements. But now let's dive into the actual contents of the table, the elements. We're going to learn about 20 different elements. I know that sounds like a lot, but you probably know more than you think already. Let's go in order of atomic number. So we'll start with number one, hydrogen. We use the element symbol H for hydrogen. Hydrogen is the lightest element in the universe. It is burning in the sun and the stars. Number two is helium. We use the symbol He. Helium is also very light, and like hydrogen, is burning in the sun and the stars. But you might know helium even more from balloons. When balloons float up in the air at a birthday party, it's because they are full of helium, and helium is so light it floats in air. Number three is lithium, the symbol Li. You might not think you know lithium, but you definitely do. Lithium is in batteries and helps to power our electronics. Number four is beryllium, with the symbol Be. You might not have seen beryllium in person, but I'm sure you know that fancy green stone called an emerald. An emerald is made of beryllium. Next step is number five, which we shorten to B, but is called boron. Boron is used in sports equipment, like tennis rackets. Number six is carbon, which we symbolize as C. Carbon is the basic element of all life. That means all living things need it to survive. Number seven is nitrogen, with the symbol N. Nitrogen is important for our bodies to be strong. That's because nitrogen is protein. Next up, perhaps the most famous element. Atomic number eight gives us oxygen, which we write as O. I'm sure you already know, but oxygen makes up the air we breathe, and humans and animals need it to survive. Number nine is fluorine, with the symbol F. But perhaps you know it better as fluoride, which is found in our toothpaste to make sure that we have strong teeth. Number 10 is neon, with the element symbol NE. I'm sure you've seen some neon signs before. A lot of businesses use neon signs to advertise that they are open because neon is so bright and glowing. Number 11 is sodium, which we use Na as a symbol. I know it seems like a funny symbol, but it will get stuck in your head. Sodium is salt. And when it is bonded with chlorine, it makes the type of salt you probably keep in your kitchen. Number 12 is magnesium, with a symbol Mg. Magnesium is used in plants and makes up chlorophyll. That's what makes plants green. The leafy green plants you eat have lots of magnesium. On to atomic number 13. We have aluminum, and we write it as Al. Aluminum is a light metal and is used to case airplanes, but you might have used it to save your leftovers. Number 14 gives us silicone, which we symbolize as Si. Silicone is used for all types of things because it's very flexible and durable. Silicone exists in rocks and soil, but maybe you've even used a silicone cup to drink a hot beverage. Atomic number 15 is phosphorus, which we symbolize with a P. Phosphorus is what our bones are made up of. Number 16 is sulfur, which we write as S. Sulfur is found in egg yolks, and funny enough, it can smell like rotten eggs. Next up, atomic number 17, which I'm sure you heard of before. It's chlorine, which we use the elemental symbol Cl. Chlorine is used in pools to keep the water clean. Number 18 is argon, with the atomic symbol AR. Argon is used in light bulbs, so you have some in your house right now. Atomic number 19 is potassium, which we give a symbol K. Potassium is found in fruits and vegetables and help your body heal from bruises and sore muscles. Last up, we have atomic number 20. This element is calcium, which we shorten to Ca. I bet you know that calcium is in milk and makes your bones strong. But did you know that calcium is also in seashells? And there you have it. Those are 20 of the most common elements we use or see in our everyday life. Keep studying and practice what you've learned by playing our online games and doing the online quizzes. Have fun and remember to always be clever. Hey.